Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon. It's 10 past two here in Tryon, and we've had a brilliant female final competition, and Germany's Christina Bowe becoming the fifth world champion for Germany. But the battle is now on for the men, because over the 28-year history since Stockholm in 1990, there have been two world champions for both France and for Germany. Germany's Michael Lehner took the opening FEI World Equestrian Games in Stockholm for Germany, and Kai Vorberg won in Aachen in 2006. And France, they are the defending champions. Jacques Ferrari won in 2014. And Matthias Lang, he won for France in 2002 in Jerez de la Frontera. And what is at stake this afternoon is who will become the eighth individual world male champion. And the battle is going to go right to the wire, with the best 15 men to come forward after the four intense days of competition. And the US have got two to come at the start of the final freestyle. They start in reverse order. And Lorenzo Lupacini, he was part of the great pas de deux victory, along with Silvia Stoppazzini two nights ago. But that is the final five, and the 18-year-old Colombian has been exceptional. Juan Martin Clavio, he starts on 8.259. He's literally within 0.3 of Lambert Leclesio's leading score. And Germany are so fancied once again, with three in the top four for Germany. Most successful nation since the World Games inception in Stockholm, with 11 individual medals for Germany. France have had five, the USA two, and Switzerland have won one medal, along with Slovakia and Denmark. Only five nations have ever claimed the world individual male title. You know the German pair and the French pair, but the USA won with Devin Matozzo. That was in 98. The games. And Denmark also, Thomas Fisbeck, he won in The Hague in 94, and it was a Swiss victory. Patrick Lusa, he won in Kentucky in 2010. And only six nations since Stockholm have ever won individual male medal. So it's a very elite band of men we're talking about. I'm delighted to have alongside me for the final 15, Hannah Eccles. Hannah, firstly, the ladies were brilliant, and the men have got quite something to match now.
Exactly, the female individual competition which we just witnessed was incredible. And for Christina Bowe as well to add champion at the FEI World Equestrian Games to her impressive list of accolades, which includes FEI World Cup winner and FEI European champion. She has done it all, and she has been such an ambassador for our sport, but the pressure is on the males now.
And it's going to be fascinating as we've enjoyed the 3 days of competition. The man who won the technical test is on top. He is the world number one. And I know your favourite for the title, Lambert Leclesio for France. And if he could win this afternoon, Hannah, the French will have won three world titles to Germany's two over the 28 years. So there's a lot at stake, both in terms of individually for Lambert and for French national pride.
Exactly. It's so, so close at the top. And it's going to be such an interesting competition. But Lambert's tech test was phenomenal. To score an 8.4 in the technical test round is testament to his class, to his quality, and he's going to bring that into this freestyle competition here, the final time we'll see him at the World Equestrian Games in Tryon.
And when we think that the top four, the three for Germany and Lambert, they're covered by only 0.151. 151,000, Hannah, cover the top four.
Yeah, there is no margin for error in this class, and the top competitors all have the possibility to take away gold. It's going to be such an exciting, thrilling competition, so let's just see what happens.
And the home crowd is very much ready, because we'll kick off with the two for the USA, who have both been superb. And we come to Christian Roberts to start off the male final here in Tryon. Christian hails from Moss Beach in California. He's just 25 years of age. This is his second World Games after Gant, where he was 11th individually. This afternoon, he is lunged by Carolyn Bland, and his horse is this big jet black Sir Charles to kick off the male final freestyle.
He had a really great first round freestyle performance, and it'd be exciting to see him try and replicate it and go even better here in the final round of the male individual class.
Yes, he was 15th in both the compulsory and the tech test, but 9th in the first freestyle. He scored 8.186 as opposed to 8.987 for Patrick Lucer, just showing how tightly punched these men are. It's tiny fractions.
Yeah, it's going to be a nail-biting competition. And Christian's also competing here in Tryon in the team for America. And he brings so much experience to that team, a vital, vital member. And we'll see him later in the squad event.
One of the most decorated athletes on the U.S. vaulting team. He's made a remarkable recovery after a badly broken leg in 2016. And just remind you, 4 technical judges, 2 on the artistic side of things, and 2 for the horse specifically. And that carries an equal weighting in the marks.
And he was so exciting to watch as well 4 years ago at the 2014 Games, especially in his pas de deux with Mary Garrett. He did such a strong, strong performance there. So Charles, move forward, going with the canter. Carlin's working hard just to maintain control.
As ever, beautifully in the mode here. Facial agony, the anguish of battle, which is certainly ensuing here in Tryon. The member of the Pacific Coast Vaulting Club, Christian Roberts, gets us off to a very strong start.
And that was really intelligent vaulting there as well, because he knew from his music that the bell was about to come. So instead of doing his usual dismount, he went for a handstand off the side, and it was so good of him, because you don't want to incur that 1 point off from both artistic judges. So well played there from Christian.
It's just 1 minute for the freestarter, jam pack with as much technical components and artistry as you can.
And you saw there, he had brilliant characterization, really gets into the theme, interprets the theme of Frankenstein. And Carolyn as well, such an incredible lunger. Lunged the American team to the gold team medal at the 2010 World Equestrian Games in Kentucky. Has so much experience.
As I say, 8 judges, 4 for technicality, 2 for artistic impression, and 2 for the horse score. 50% of their marks for the technical aspects, 25 for each of the horse and the artistry, which he'll certainly score very highly on.
He always has such confidence with his vaulting, such strong performances. And he had to work hard for that freestyle there.
Just the one slightly disappointing mark there, the technical aspects from Rob de Bruyn for the Netherlands, which is a little bit out of kilter from the others.
So the technical score is made up of degree of difficulty and then the deductions of those difficult moves as well. So it's really important that you have an action-packed routine, but it has to be performed really well in harmony with the horse.
And 7.263 is the first completion score of this 15 strong male final showdown for the FEI World Equestrian Games.
And you saw there as well, for the first round freestyle, he was awarded an 8.1, and I can't highlight enough how fantastic that freestyle round was for Christian. Today just wasn't quite as in harmony with his horse, Sir Charles.
Well, I apologise if you've been deaf and down the transmission, because there's a screaming group in front of us to welcome in Colton Palmer. And why not? He's such a young man, 19 years of age, from the Half Moon Bay Club in California.
He has really been thrilling the audiences here in Tryon with such incredible, vibrant performances, and it just shows his vast improvement over the past couple of years. It's crazy.
Colton making his World Equestrian Games debut. He was in Le Mans, the Worlds of 2016, 13th as an individual. His whole family dedicated to vaulting. Sisters Cassidy and Kimberly competed as a pas de deux partnership on the US team in Normandy 4 years ago. He starts on 7.499. He lies in 14th Cameron position. He's about 1.1 back of Lambert Leclesio, the world number ones. Hall, which is 8.572, just to give you a context.
He's such thrilling quality to his vaulting, a very different style, and what a dynamic start from Colton. Great start to the freestyle. Nice Maltese lever.
Colton has risen to the top in just 3 years. His first international start was at just 16 years of age, 3 years ago. So a late starter, but boy, he shot to the top.
We talk about new, exciting, talented prospects, and he is one of those guys. Wow.
Oh, and hold the landing, why don't you? It was a huge dismount, Hannah. His knees were double flexed and he just stuck it awesomely. That's what 19 years of age can do for Lahani, but that was simply brilliant.
I'm just so impressed by his improvement over the past couple of years. It really is breathtaking. And if this is what he can achieve now, what can he go on to in the future? Such a skilled vaulter. It's the way he connects and links move together. It's really unique. And I think he's such a thrilling prospect together with his horse Zygo as well. Just brilliant.
Yes, when you think that the US have only won the world title once in 98 with Devon Matoso. Devon also won the bronze in 02 in Jerez. I could imagine that Colton could well become the next one for the USA on that sort of a performance.
Yeah, definitely. I'm so impressed by his vaulting here. I haven't seen him in competition for over a year. And the improvement in that time has been so fast. Look at the control on the Maltese lever here. It's a risk move, brilliant control, up into the handstand, down to the bum.
Yeah, when you think he's 19, he's still developing physically, but the strength to hold that horizontal. Strength movement, watch this dismount. Bam! Unbelievable.
And we mentioned the fact that he's been doing college gymnastics. And I think that really shows in his vaulting and in the improvement with his vaulting.
Anna, we've been watching dismounts all week. And that is one of the first I've seen landed plumb. And there is the reward. 8.214 for 19-year-old Colton Palmer. Magnificent.
Yeah, he will be thrilled with that. He's had such a great showing at these World Equestrian Games. And he's really made everybody sit up and take notice of his vaulting. Definitely one to watch for the future. Such an exciting prospect, and we do have so much young talent here in Tryon.
He's had a wonderful week. 14th after compulsory, 12th after the first freestyle, and 13th after the technical test. And Colton Palmer has had a simply brilliant first World Equestrian Games, and as we're saying, a big future lies ahead of him. 7.678.
Exactly, and you see that he got high artistic scores across the board as well there, because the freestyle is put together very cleverly. He's moving across the horse to encompass the entirety of the horse, and he has a good variation of exercises and a good mix between static and dynamic movements as well.
Well, Italy has never won an individual male medal. Surprisingly, with the flair and the panache of the Italians, but that incredible performance from Silvia Stoppacini and Lorenzo Lupacini gave them part of their team gold just two nights ago. And three Italians coming back to back here. The first of them is Francesco Bortoletto. Francesco, 25 years of age. He's in his second World Games, having been sixth with the Italian squad in Normandy. 12th individually at the Worlds in Le Mans 2 years ago, but his debut individually at the Worlds.
I've been so impressed by the improvement in Italian vaulting over the past years. They've become a real dominant force in the sport, and it's really exciting to watch.
Rosenstolz just needs to have a moment to relax after out of your picture, an exuberant leap off the sand, because they're not, of course, immune to this kind of atmosphere. It's still fairly humid in here, mid-20s outside. A little bit more air than the preceding week.
Jump now. Jump in front of the car. Go on. Do it.
This horse is just phenomenal. As we said, it won gold with Silvia and Lorenzo in the Pas de Deux. And Laura, the lunger, she said she had to work really hard because Rosenstolz was also feeling the nerves. But what a beautiful horse with a great movement.
Francesco starting on 7.596. He's about 1 point back of Lambert Leclesio's lead score.
Nice variation on the Maltese lever there. Putting one hand on the pad. He will also join Silvia and Lorenzo later for Italy in the score competition. We are seeing a great quality of vaulting in this class, and I love the fact that all different competitors bring a different style and flair to the competition, and that's what makes it so exciting. He definitely has a very different style to what we just witnessed from Colton Palmer.
He's quite a tall athlete, and he's solidly built. I think just a slightly slower tempo than we have seen, but every move performed superbly, precise, but not quite that high dynamic tempo we have seen.
Yeah, definitely a different variation of freestyle. But he is such a vital member of the Italian squad too.
And to be precisely fair, Christina Boe actually didn't have the highest tempo compared to some of those that came before her, and it took her to the world title. So we can't just say it's about speed and dynamicism, or however we say it.
But what Christina Boe does have is amazing characterization and storytelling, and you see all the competitors really trying to work on that element and bring it more into their performance, because it also does contribute to the artistic score from the judges. Rosenstolz nice and relaxed there, coming again in just a second.
I think I added a syllable, just dynamism, I think we'll do dynamism. That's what happens when you live in Italy, you see. When I live near Turin, so I get infiltrated with overpronunciation on, you know, anything to do with E, I or O, it can cause havoc with the commentator. But I'm not going back to England in its current state. So, exciting times for Francesco Bortoletto. We think some sort of disturbed mental patient, we think.
And what's so interesting as well is the Italian vaulters' work ethic. They work so hard on their physicality and athleticism, and they have invested so much in their horses the past years, and that's reflected in the horse scores that you see from Rosenstolz. As we said, it makes up 25% of the total mark, and that is judged by judges A and judges E.
Acknowledging our crowd here, and they're a cracking crowd. 7.774 for Francesco Bortoletto. And Rosenstolz, who comes again in just a moment for the man that was part of that, well, show-stopping Pas de Deux. It was at 8 o'clock on Thursday night that Lorenzo and Silvia became the Pas de Deux world champions. And that was just electric. I mean, I re-watched it last night, Hannah, and it was something else.
Yeah, I still get goosebumps when I think about that moment, because Silvia and Lorenzo have worked hard, and it was the accumulation of all their hard work. And they really brought a new energy to the competition. It was fantastic.
And energy is going to be abundant here for sure. The Laurel and Hardy theme comes to the front for the Pas de Deux World Champion. Lorenzo Lupacini comes forward. He starts on 7.7 precisely. So 0.802 behind Lambert Leclercio. He is, in fact, at his very first World Equestrian Games, which makes that Padada all the more special. He was in Le Mans, the Worlds. When I say Worlds, I mean the interspersing Worlds. That's your vaulting Worlds as opposed to the FEI World Equestrian Games, just to be clear to everybody. He was at the Worlds in 2016 for 11th position individually with this horse, Rochenstolz. And 9th individually, again with him in Ibersdorf at the Europeans last year.
And what Lorenzo and Sylvia have managed to achieve in the sport, making history for Italy as the first ever Italian vaulters to win a gold medal for them at the World Equestrian Games. Last year, they were the first Italian vaulters to win gold at the Europeans. They are just record breakers.
He's had a great recovery as well after that broken foot, which ruled him out of the World Cup finals in Dortmund. His 9th individually. Regardless, in Aachen. Beautiful cartwheel. So supple across his back there. He must be in seriously confident mood here.
His great versatility. He's flexible, strong, but he can also tell a story. I love that performance from Lorenzo. Another great freestyle from him at the World Equestrian Games.
And easy to forget, he's still only 22 years of age. A man with many years ahead of him at the top of male vaulting.
We will see him again later in the squad competition for Italy, but this is the last time we'll see Rosenstolz here at the World Equestrian Games in Tryon. And what an unbelievable horse Rosenstolz is.
The two concepts I know in Italian are grazie mille for the performance and meraviglioso, magnificent. That's what I would say to Lorenzo Lupacini. Congratulations.
And you see Sylvia there as well. I spoke to her yesterday and she was talking about the fact that they have such a brilliant friendship. And it's really affected both their lives, not only in what they are able to achieve in the sport, but having a real bearing on both of them as individuals.
But Hannah, you can't achieve what they've done without that closeness. I mean, the training hours, the need to speak before and after training about things to work on, it's got to lead to a super bond.
Exactly, and they perfectly complement each other. And you talk about the training hours. They're also training individual, pas de deux, and team. It's just phenomenal how they are able to split their time and give each separate competition and category their dedication and full commitment.
And Lorenzo's been upping the ante. 12th on day one, 15th after the first freestyle and 7th in the technical test. So he is moving up the leaderboard.
Wow, what a score for Lorenzo in that freestyle, 8.518. Brilliant scores across the board, but certainly from the technical judges, achieving a 9 from Judge F.
Yes, Doris Knotter from Austria, rightly impressed. Just remind you of our judges. They've been the same over the 4 days of competition, but it's Helma Schwarzman at A for the horse. Karolina Vikkonen for Finland. Oh, we'll come to that in a moment. 7.905. Takes a very good lead. Then we have at C, Suzanne Detoff for the USA, the artistic judge. The finish judge at B for technique. Rob de Bruyn is also on technique at D. Suzanne Detoff for the horse, along with Helma Schwarzman. Doris Knotter, as you know, the technique judge at F. And Veronique Girard, the artistic judge at G. And Gabby Benz for Italy, the technical judge at H. They are our 8 judges here in Tryon.
And we're really disappointed that Anna Cavallaro had to pull out from the competition due to that injury. But what she has done blazing the trail for Italian vaulting has been phenomenal, and really a lot of this success is also a testament to what she has been able to achieve in the sport.
And we're hoping for a similar gear shift in Southern America as well with the Colombian Juan Martin Clavio. At 18, he's the fifth best after the 3 days, but we stay now with the young guns for Italy, even younger, and the second youngest in the competition. We welcome Giovanni Bertolaso, his debut at the FEI World Equestrian Games. He was in the world in Le Mans, 10th individually 2 years ago with Hermé du Beaumont. And he was in last year's Europeans in Ibersdorf as an individual, 5th place there. And this man could really deliver something special here.
Exactly. He has been highly impressive throughout the duration of this competition, really making a name for himself in the vaulting world. And he's easily made the jump up from the junior level to the senior level, and it's great to see him here so competitive. This is such an emotive freestyle.
We are within 0.8 of the gold medal score at the moment. Giovanni off to great start.
Look at the quality of his movements. You can really see the inspiration of Anna Cavallaro throughout.
He's pretty much got the perfect frame for vault, hasn't he? He's compact, but he's got elegance as well, and as you see, severe flexibility.
Such a variety of components. She's able to perform with ease and grace. That's the only disappointment there, is the fact that the bell went before he started his back summy dismount. But apart from that, a flawless routine from Giovanni.
So Giovanni Bertolaso, he's been such a star this week. And again, like Colton Palmer, like Juan Martin Clavio, they're going to be battling out for the world titles, I think, over the next 15 years, I'd imagine.
Yes, definitely. If this is them now, at the inception of their careers, just think what they can go on to achieve. They are phenomenal. And you see it in the quality of the movements throughout. They also have a great repertoire. They really compose very clever, very difficult freestyles, but they bring such emotion to the competition.
And Nelson Vedoni has been such a huge part of Italian vaulting. Monaco Franzi is a lunger today, and Monaco was also in Ibersdorf last year, the Europeans, with Giovanni. So they're a super trio, and very exciting to see how this young man progresses.
Yeah, and you mentioned Nelson there. He has done so much for the sport, and we talked about the quality of the Italian horses. Monaco is also brilliant, and it's just great to see this partnership between the three of them really become so competitive in this class.
We are one third of the way through the male final freestyle here in Tryon, and it's going to be an Italian leader come what may.
He has all the attributes that you're looking for in a future champion, so we definitely need to keep an eye on him, because he has such quality, such finesse, but he delivers it in his own style, and I think for the future, such an exciting prospect. And we said how crucial as well the junior championships are in cultivating talent, and we've really seen that with Giovanni. He went through the junior levels, and now he's properly competitive on the senior stage.
8.328. With a brilliant mark from Gabby Benz on the technical side of things. 8.328, he goes into second place as we stand in terms of the freestyle, but we wait for his overall mark.
Yeah, and that is a phenomenal score, but remember, 1 point came off from both artistic judges, so just think how high that could have been. He is a formidable talent.
And just drops down behind Lorenzo Lupacini on that golden surge, Lorenzo, after the Pas de Deux performance. But it's a brilliant performance, his debut at the FEI World Equestrian Games, for Giovanni Bertolaso.
If you're looking for showmanship, look no further than Bala Spence. He is a sight to behold. He is always entertaining, and he will not disappoint here.
And his lunger here, Devon Mitoso, the world champion from Rome in 1998, and the bronze 4 years later in Jerez de la Frontera. So a really experienced team here, and yes, this Hungarian has been giving us dazzling, energetic, difficult performances all week long.
Yeah, he was definitely a crowd favourite here in the first round freestyle. He has such energy, as you mentioned. Fascinating to watch. And Devon himself had been hoping to qualify for this World Equestrian Games, but unfortunately had an injury which meant he couldn't compete here.
It's again the first World Equestrian Games for Bala Spence, and again, 22 years of age. Let's not exclude him out of our future world champion brackets. He was 11th last year in Eibersdorf, the European Championships. And this year, 6th in Dortmund.
He's doing a traditional Hungarian theme, yet he's still able to bring such humour to the performance.
It's kind of a great mix, isn't it, between precision and accuracy, but the casualness and just the sheer natural flair from Bala Spence.
Just missing the backwards jump, but brilliant dismount. Another fascinating performance from him. He really is a showman.
The kind of routine you just couldn't copy. I mean, it's totally unique. It's like nothing else you've seen over the 4 days. It's brilliant.
No, you definitely, it's really hard to teach vaulters that level of showmanship. It's something that's inbuilt with him. And he's always able to bring such an energy. He's done it for many years. And that is why he's such a favorite within the vaulting world, because he is so fascinating to watch.
And aside from the energy, Hannah, it's very unique in terms of move sequences, just move individual grasps. I mean, it's nothing like, have you seen nothing like it?
Exactly, and the artistic judge is also looking for highlights within the freestyle, and he definitely is able to bring a different style of vaulting to the fore.
So Bala Spence is the world ranked number 6 in both the World Cup standings and the overall FEI vaulting rankings. Gives another high energy performance with a unique twist on things like that cross-legged stand.
That is his signature move.
Such a cool dismount.
Yeah, you definitely want to finish with a highlight for both judges, the artistic judges and the technical judges. It's very, very important that you finish with a big dismount, and he achieves that with ease.
And the abdominal strength, not to need to grasp the dismount, just to do it all freestyle in the air, is remarkable. 8.369, the second best of the men's final freestyle here for Bala Spence. It's going to be really tight here, but I think he's going to just get the nod on Lorenzo Lupacini.
And that is a really good score from him, but it is also testament to the quality of the vaulting that we're seeing in the individual male class. And really, we've seen it throughout the duration of the competition, because the quality of vaulting has been unprecedented, a great representation of global vaulting.
And there it is. He does get the nod. It's tiny fractions. It's 12 thousandths of a point only that separate our new leader. Bala Spence and Maximilian go out into the lead of the pair, or the three chasing Italians.
Yeah, I'm thrilled for him, because he does bring such a unique quality to the competition, and he is just so entertaining to watch. The showmanship is unmatched, and again, just continue to watch him in the future, because he will be up there challenging for the medals at the senior level as well. Great reaction there. You see exactly what it means to do such a great performance at the World Equestrian Games. I was so thrilled for Lucas to be part of Team Switzerland, which won the silver medal in the national team championship earlier in the week. It was highly deserved, because he has given so much to the sport over the years, and he really is an exciting individual to watch.
Lucas Hepler comes forward, ranked number 5 in the FBI vaulting rankings. He's been vaulting for now 16 years of age and 5 times Swiss champion. It's Jacqueline Koenig, who designs his great costumes for competition. And when he's not vaulting, he's a kite surfer and a keen skier as well. All sports which will help him harness the balance and the energy required to try and climb this leaderboard at the moment in 9th position. He starts on 7.780, within again about 0.9. It's that tight, covering the top 9 men worldwide.
Yeah, we spoke about how challenging the technical test round, especially under intense pressure, and he had that slip off the side of Accardi in the jump to backwards, which was hugely disappointing for him, but I'm hoping that he can finish off his FEI World Equestrian Games campaign here with a great freestyle round. He's another one that has a great quality to his vaulting, and also the unique ability to transfer his vaulting onto multiple different horses, which we saw through the FEI World Cup season through the winter.
In the dark, right on the middle mark, just in the tear.
Creative start for Lucas Hepler. His second World Games, 9th he was in Normandy. And I love these 360 spins. He's landed them brilliantly all week.
Yeah, look how soft he is on the cardi. That's what I love about his vaulting. It's so harmonious and great to watch. It's great horsemanship throughout his vaulting.
And a double benefit, Hannah, there. Land soft on the horseback, don't bruise him. Be respectful to your horse, and also to land softly on the balls of your feet so you don't unbalance yourself as a vaulter backwards.
And it was just so brilliant to see him win that silver medal, his first FAI medal, and what a way to do it at the World Equestrian Games. Brilliant. Great freestyle there from Lucas. So strong, and you see the quality to his vaulting throughout.
And the dismount, again, superb, but he had that extra sort of little kick of energy to bounce out of it. It's a super performance.
Yeah, he is brilliant. And okay, he had that slip off the side in the technical test round, but he is such a strong competitor, and we will definitely see him at future championships challenging for the medals in the individual male class.
He was right up in contention after the compulsories on day one. And then he was very strong in the first freestyle, with a performance like that, 8.516 it was then, the 5th position. As Hannah's saying, disappointing in that technical test with 14th on 6.833, but he certainly finished with a really strong performance.
Yeah, I'm just so thrilled for him to be able to show that round as his final time here at the Tryon FEI World Equestrian Games. Because he deserves it, because he does give so much to the sport. We saw that throughout the Winter World Cup season. And the quality of his form throughout the moves really does give the judges limited opportunity for deductions.
The Swiss flags decorating this indoor stadium, and it was that brilliant team silver. Lucas was an individual in that silver behind Germany, and there is the score, 8.755. look at the marks at D, G and H and B as well, all above 9. That is very, very much heavy hitting.
Yeah, exactly. It is testament to the quality of his vaulting, and I'm so excited by the partnership of him, Accardi and Monica as well. They are a great, great partnership, and it's so exciting for the future.
And that is lovely to see. He's sort of so proud that his hard work and his delivery have been rewarded with huge marks. An 8.024, he goes well out of the lead of Balázs Benz and the Italians that are chasing.
Yeah, he is definitely just brilliant. I mean, apart from that one slip in the jump to backwards, apart from that, the quality of his vaulting throughout this championship has been great. And we'll see him on many, many more championship stages in the future.
But now get ready, because this man has been electrifying all week. It's Dominik Eder for Austria. Again, 22 years of age. This is his debut at the FBI World Equestrian Games. He was at the Worlds as an individual in Le Mans 2 years ago for 19th position, but this is some hoik up the world rank. He starts in 8th position. He's been very consistent, 9th, 10th and 10th in the 3 days preceding. But this man, I've got a notion here, he could do something special.
The World Equestrian Games is the biggest stage for us as vaulters. And it's been so great to see so many competitors peaking at the perfect moment and really rising to the occasion, showing their best in Tryon.
He showed his class in Aachen, Frank Kemperman's World Equestrian Festival, in mid-July with 6th with Leocardo Pepetto. Just a one start for this horse this season already in Eichbrechtsdorf at home in Austria. That was 5th in May. He had a great win again with Leocardo. That was in Pezenok in June. He's got serious strength for a young man.
You're right, he is so strong and he's really worked on his artistry over the past couple of years.
He's therefore a typical man, and I'd expect that.
Such impressive physicality to his vaulting, and that comes from the fact that he also competes in squad at CVIs throughout the year.
Got the strength there to lift himself up on his right elbow. It's phenomenal. Just had to grab the handle for a moment to balance, but otherwise it's flawless.
And together, him and Pepetto have really grown in confidence.
Dominik Eder completes superb performance.
And you see that the pattern is back there from his father, Martin. And I think to be able to come to America and compete on the World Equestrian Games stage and share those memories, unforgettable memories, what an experience they will have had here. And he really is making a huge name for himself.
Interesting again, because we've had this a few times today already. The world ranking reflected by their positioning in this final leaderboard, which is certainly showing the strength of those world rankings. He's number 8 in the world and he starts as number 8 in this final shootout. So going to rise though, Hannah, he must, because he's only 22.
And that's what I love about the final that we're having here at the World Equestrian Games, is there's such a great mix of vaulters, from the experienced vaulters who have been around for a long time to really new, exciting, up-and-coming talent who, you know, in the future they will be going head-to-head for the medals.
And he also is part of a team bronze for the squad for Austria in Aachen. In addition to that, 6th place individually. And what I love personally is the fact that these younger men are competing with more experienced, more senior vaulters, and still coming right up on their heels. But with the years to come, that just shows what is going to happen with some of these young guys.
Exactly, and they really do add vibrancy to the sport and to the event, because they really are pushing the levels. It's thrilling to watch, and you see that reflected in his freestyle score there.
Very strong indeed, and both technical judges at F and H have gone up over 9. The second best of the men's freestyle final so far.
And we talked about the improvement by Dominik, but it's also important to talk about the improvement of Pepetto. It's so great to see them growing in confidence together, and I think just such a thrilling partnership for the future.
So Lucas Hepler, who really delivered a knockout final freestyle, he stays just ahead of Dominik Eder. Just only one man above 8 points on 8.024, but now he starts to climb up just 0.005 of a point ahead of Dominik. We welcome Clément Taillet.
I mean, the fact that we haven't even watched the top 7 yet, and we're already seeing scores posted between 8.5 and 8.7. It's just testament to the incredible quality, harmony and skill we have witnessed throughout this competition.
Clermont is competing in his second World Games after Normandy 4 years ago. Not an individual there, but team bronze in the squad. He hails from Strasbourg. He studies sports science at Strasbourg University. And he is an employee at his father's architectural office. He needs to not design a freestyle, he needs to sculpt a freestyle now to try and better Lucas Hepler.
I love his style of vaulting. Last year we saw him compete with more classical freestyle, and this year he's going for an edgy theme. It's great to see the variation that he can bring to the competition.
His sister Claire was selected to represent France in the vaulting 4 years ago in Normandy. And his lunger, Cédric Cotin-Holzberg, has been instrumental in his young career.
I just see echoes of your indecision. Don't ask me.
And he's won multiple medals for France in squad competition in the past. He's so elegant with his movements.
And second in the World Cup final this year in Dortmund. He looks under no sort of pressure.
He always makes vaulting look so easy, and that's what you're trying to achieve and convey to the judges. Look at the height of that jump.
Super dismount once again. They're punching holes in the sand in this men's final freestyle.
It's so impressive. I love the soft, elegant quality of his vaulting contrasted against the edgy music choice. It's brilliant to see.
Their last win was in the French capital in Paris, early December last year. And I must say, I love his motto. He says, I think we can have many strategies for work and personal belongings, but vaulting should be something pure. He then said, to win the world title would not change your life, but the process to become a world champion fills your life with inner joy, and that is the change. Philosophical.
Yeah, he has a great mindset, and it is reflected in his vaulting, but it's also due to the partnership that he has with Dairon and also Cedric. They are such an established team, and that's why he vaults with such confidence.
I thought exactly the same having read the quote, watching his performance, because that freedom to really just enjoy this stage, that is what results in this kind of a performance overall.
Yeah, there is no stress there. He looks at utter ease, confident with the placing of every single move. It's just breathtaking to watch, and he always brings such vibrancy to the event, and he's done that again here in Tryon. Definitely putting pressure on the remaining competitors.
5,000ths above Dominic Ader and above Lucas Hepler, our current leader, 6,000ths. So we wait 8.467.
Still a good score, but you also see that the horse score is slightly lower than we've seen for previous horses, say like Rosenstolz. And that's reflected in the marks given by Judge A and Judge E, but I have to admit, I loved that freestyle. He has such a great quality as vaulting. He's so entertaining, and that is what he brought to the table today.
Yeah, just like the horse scores letting him down, they've been a great combination. And that's just one of those things, Hannah, as we were saying earlier in the week, you can't just affect that. That's just the way things are generally.
But at the same time, sometimes you'll find that the vaulters who are at the top, they aren't necessarily competing on the highest scoring horses. And we saw that with Christina Bo earlier. Dondalmar isn't the highest scoring horse in the competition, but she has that relationship, that partnership that means she can vault effectively.
Yeah, exactly. Just to explain to our viewers further. So you might choose a slightly lower horse score because of the partnership, because of the trust, because of the advantages you gain. That's
yeah,
the point.
Exactly. You can have that established relationship, trust. And sometimes you'll find that a bigger canter can be slightly harder to vault on. So it's trying to find a balance between the highest scoring horse and also having the trust and established partnership.
We are into the last six, and two of those are for France and three for Germany. And as we have said, over the last seven World Championship cycles. France has won two and Germany two as well. So the battle on now for supremacy between the traditional rivals as we welcome forward Vincent Hanno. And Vincent is going to set off any moment aboard this gorgeous Ultra Chic HDC.
It's great to see the two club mates, Vincent and Clément, go one after the other. And we talked about how Clément and Duron are an established pairing. And this is the first time I've seen Vincent compete with Ultra Chic, but it's been a brilliant partnership so far.
Seventh last time out in Normandy. And he starts in seventh, unbelievably. Après Holzberger at the end of the lunge for Ultra Chic. And rank number three in the world here.
This is his 10-10 interpretation. And he has great gymnastic skill that he's able to bring to the freestyle.
He's had a super season. Win in Marsella. The Côte d'Orbiche, the highlights so far this year.
And winning the silver medal 2 years ago at the World Championships, we know he can perform on the biggest stage.
And this horse has got a very nice fluent style in the canter. Not quite as bouncy as we've seen, but it just keeps the back a little bit more stable that Vincent can really go to town as he's doing now.
Yeah, I love this horse. It competes with a team from his club in France. And it reminds me of a horse they used to have called Watriano, who was phenomenal, but brilliant freestyle from Vincent.
Vincent Hanno has been with the horses since he was 6 years of age, combining both riding and gymnastics. He had a break as well from his vaulting career for 5 years because of the difficulties of university and his brilliant sport of vaulting. In fact, it was 2007 when he came back full-time into the vaulting.
And he's a previous junior medalist, and he's really been able to make the jump up to the senior level very easily because he has such great gymnastic skill, and he's worked so hard on his characterization over the past few years. But I love the new partnership with Ultra Chic, even though we're used to seeing him compete with Quartz Dobliche.
As we say, two left for France, two scores, and the performance of our leader after 3 days, Lambert Leclerciot, to come. The French world champions, the first was in 2002, Mathias Lang, won in Jerez de la Frontera in Spain, and the reigning champion is Jacques Ferrari, not here. But they are France's two wins at the FEI World Equestrian Games. And a two for Germany, Michael Lehner, the first ever in Stockholm, and that famous win at home in Aachen for Germany's Kai Vorberg, the two apiece.
And the French are renowned for the quality of their male vaulters as well. Always so competitive in this class, challenging for the gold medal.
And aside from those world titles, they've won 5 medals in total, an 8.759. Best so far, and we're just at the halfway point.
Yeah, that is a brilliant score and thoroughly deserved, but it is this new partnership with Ultra Chic that I think is so exciting, and it's brought new vitality to his vaulting. They look very comfortable together, like they've been together for a long, long time.
So Lucas Hepler has finally been toppled off top spot. He'd been climbing. But congratulations to Vincent Hanno, who takes the lead with just 5 more to come. Germany 11 medals, France 5, the USA with 2, both for Devon Matoso, who's lunged this afternoon. Switzerland, Slovakia and Denmark with 1 apiece, the only 6 nations to ever win medals in this highly competitive but very sort of streamlined into the nations sport of vaulting.
Exactly, and that's why it's so exciting to have Juan Martin Clavigo here vaulting for Colombia.
The youngest in the field bounds forward. We have been delighted by Juan Martin Clavigo. He hails from the Colombian capital, Bogota. His sister Sylvia came to Normandy 4 years ago, and he was part of the squad for Colombia in Caen, but his very first individual start, and he has been brilliant.
He is a breathtaking talent. He really is something else, and we saw that reflected in his 2 gold medals at the Junior World Championship. But it's been so easy for him to step up to the senior level, and the tech test 2 days ago was phenomenal.
He's only about 0.28 behind Lambert Leclercio on 8.259 as opposed to 8.572. As you say, Hannah, second last time out on day 3. 5th in the compulsories and 6th in the opening freestyle. Back at the start of the vaulting week. This is Freak under the handle of Jill Palmer. And I can't wait to see what this young star can do now.
He's a great ambassador for our sport. He's done so much to grow the sport. And look at how expressive he is with his movement. To change the routine fractionally there. Brilliant flexibility and control.
Juan Martin Clavio is showing serious artistic flair here, as you would expect, and he nails his landing. Youngest in the competition. He has been a breath of fresh air this week, and I think he has got world champion in the years to come written all over him.
He's just so expressive. He has a great lyrical movement, and the way he's able to compose the freestyle is always so breathtaking to watch. But yes, he will definitely be up there in the future as well, challenging for the gold medal at the World Equestrian Games.
And the story is so unique. At just 5 years of age, his parents took him and his sister to a riding school, not knowing it was a vaulting school. That is the remarkable story which has led to this man eventually coming to triumph.
And we talk about the vaulters that have the established partnership with their horses. And Juan's competing here on a borrowed horse, and it's just testament to the skill of his vaulting that he can transfer over so easily. But Freak, who he's competing on here, is such a bright young talent as well. Great partnership and so exciting for the future.
And Juan Martin needs his own horse in Colombia because he's still practicing on the 4 horses that are owned by his trainer. I'd love a wealthy backer to get behind him, because if they can support him, anything's possible.
And he's doing so much to grow the sport globally.
I mean, it's a bit like a golfer going to play at the Masters without his own clubs. You know, borrow some clubs and see how you get on. That is what he's basically doing.
And it's testament to the quality of his vaulting that he can be so harmonious on multiple different equine partners. And also we have to mention Jill Palmer as well, whose son Colton competed earlier in the class, and it really is testament to the camaraderie and community within vaulting.
The double junior European champion. He won last year in Austria, and he won in 2015 at Ermelo in the Netherlands. His debut here, 8.480. He's got the one above the 9 from Alina Vickholm for the technical aspects. She's clearly very impressed.
Yeah, as we said, the technical score is a reflection of the difficulty in his program and the way he's able to perform those difficult exercises. And he is just a phenomenal talent, and it's great to see such a high total combined score from Juan.
And he's really put his foot to the gas. Second in the technical test, and 8.314, with just 4 more to come. Well done, Juan Martin, simply.
We spoke about how the technical test part of the competition had the ability to shake up the leaderboard, and that's exactly what it did with Tommy here. He had been lying in first place and he's currently in fourth. So it'll be interesting to see if he can come back and make his way into the medals.
Thomas Brusewitz, 24 years of age. World rank number 7. Part of the famous Brusewitz brothers with his brother not here sadly, Victor. Victor, who was also at the World Games in 2014. And Thomas was fourth individually in Caen aboard Airbus. Let's hope for a flying start to his routine here. This is Danny Boy about to get underway. As Hannah says, he led both the compulsories. The first freestyle just dropped down a little bit with the tech test, but he's still on 8.421 within point 151 of the leading score.
And Tommy has already taken a gold medal away from the championships here as part of the squad that competed in the national team championship. Can he add more to his collection?
He's a true showman. The Gala Nights, the big horse shows all over Europe. The Brusewitz brothers perform at. And he's been a state level swimmer as well, which explains the muscular, powerful frame, which he's harnessing to top effect.
Showing great execution of his exercises so far. We have to mention Patrick Luther as well, his lunger, 2010 gold medalist from Kentucky. And here comes the back-facing backflip. Just a little bit hard down on the neck of Danny Boy, but managed to maintain control.
He would be the tallest vaulter in the men's competition at 1.80 meters. And all tight on the bell, Hannah. Did he land it in time?
I think he had started the dismount before the bell, which is crucial. But what I would say as well from that freestyle is that back-facing backflip is so, so tricky. And he is the only vaulter in the world that has ever attempted it. Just groundbreaking what he's able to achieve in the sport.
And like the showman he is, he finishes just on the barrier. Super week he's had. And Thomas Brusewitz now putting pressure on to try and improve on his fourth place 4 years ago. And it's only literally 0.02 20,000 Hannah, that separates Thomas from Yannis Drew, who's the next to come. It's that tight now.
Yeah, it's unbelievably tight at the top, and we have to mention Danny Boy as well. What a fantastic horse. Also carrying the squad from Germany here at the World Equestrian Games, yet still has the energy to give us great rhythm, great impulsion. And here's the back-facing backflip. You see, just managing to hold the landing, but still, what an exercise to try and put in under pressure. Phenomenal. And there we had the big dismount at the end from Tommy, always finishing with a bang. He's renowned for his dismounts.
So Thomas Brusewitz has a moment to regroup before the scores come through, having nailed the freestyle. 8.868. Three judges go above 9. The technical judge at B, at F, Doris Carter again for technique, and at H, Gavi Benz from Italy again. His technique has all been hugely rewarded, understandably so.
Yeah, phenomenal scores across the board, but we also have to talk about Danny Boy posting an 8.2 and an 8.5. That is testament to the quality of Danny Boy's canter. Such an amazing horse as well. This will put pressure on the remaining three competitors.
Yes, I'm glad you always bring it back to the horses, because they are crucial to the performance. We've seen if they don't retain their calmness, their rhythm and their impulsion, it's virtually impossible for these vaulters to keep sustaining their energy. It's a real, like their diving board, isn't it, in a swimming pool. Diving board stands still, you hit the diving board, not the water nicely.
Exactly, and Danny Boy is competing in both squad and individual here in Tryon, and still has the energy to maintain great impulsion throughout the routine.
We are into the final three. Germany are guaranteed a bronze medal because of that super performance from Thomas Brusewitz. And of the final three, it's two for Germany and the leader for France as the crowd hushes for Yanis Drul, 27 years of age. He's from Steinhagen in the west of Germany. He started vaulting at just 8 years of age. And he's world ranked number two, both in the World Cup and the individual standings. Remarkably, his first ever World Games, but 2 years ago in Le Mans at the Worlds, he was individual bronze medal winner. And this year and last year, World Cup final champion in Dortmund.
We talk about vaulters that have innate showmanship, and he is one of those vaulters. He always gets into character. We're used to seeing him compete with Diablis and his mother, Simona Drul, on a lunge. Here's the leader, Lars Hansen, Feliciano, who also has the ability to score really high in this competition.
Dancing with Wolves as the Wolf Scream. We welcome Yanis Drul forward. An almost sullen look as if he contemplates the huge task awaiting him. As Thomas Brusewitz has posted a great score, 8.533 to beat. And his advantage, 0.02 exactly, 20 thousandths.
Wow, look at the height on that jump. There's never hesitation in his freestyle. Great movement throughout the exercises. Working hard with Feliciano here.
And the dismount again after a flawless performance was nailed, Hannah.
He is just brilliant. He is so strong, and it's the way he's able to complete such difficult movements, like the ground bounces, for instance. They're so complex, and he does it with ease. Utter commitment to the freestyle.
And further impressive is that he was injured quite heavily in 2017, sorry. He had surgery on the meniscus in his knee, 13 weeks off to go on to the silver at the Europeans just 8 weeks later. Incredible power of recovery. And he was 2015 and 2016's best male vaulter of the year, the award granted by the FEI.
And he's always so entertaining, and that's what makes him a fan favorite, because he is such a showman. Complete commitment. Great to see his mother, Simona, there.
And military precision in his performance, not only with the Dancers of Wolves theme with the US Army, but also because he's part of the Bundeswehr Sportschule in Warendorf. That super system to really help their young sportsmen and women with military training. A good friend of mine, Andres Ostol, the chief running instructor at the Bundeswehr, was one unlucky not to make the cut for the German eventing team here. Great performance, four. Yanis Drul, and we wait.
You saw in the slow motion replay there, his form is exceptional, and that is reflected in the score, an 8.711. Great scores across the board from the horse, technical and artistic judges, but what will that mean for the leaderboard?
Yes, very good marks from both Vic Holm at B and Gabby Bentz at H, but he just slips in behind Thomas Brusewitz. So Thomas maintains his advantage, and that guarantees him a bronze medal. Thomas Brusewitz has got the bronze, come what may.
The two performances that we just witnessed will definitely put pressure on both Yannick and Lombard to come. But as you mentioned, a guaranteed least bronze medal for Thomas Brusewitz, and he is so deserving of that medal.
.042, 42 thousandths only ahead of Yannis Druhl lies Yannick Hyland. He's the last of the men's freestyle here at the FBI World Equestrian Games in Tryon for Germany. As we say, Germany 2 world titles over the 28-year history and France 2. So this is now vital for Yannick Hyland to try and lift Germany's third as the most successful nation of men's world vaulting, and we know the females just the same.
And he has already taken a gold medal from these championships here in Tryon as part of Team Germany that won gold in the national team championship earlier in the week. Can he add another to his collection?
And surprisingly, his first World Equestrian Games.
This is one of the greatest pianists of Poland.
He was sixth individually at the Europeans in Le Mans in 2011. Individual silver.
Music.
At the Junior Europeans in Austria 2010. But this year we saw his class with the third individually at the World Cup final in Dortmund.
Utter elegance throughout.
And one lucky omen is he hails from Sievertal near Hamburg, not far from where Christina Bowe is also based.
They're training partners, and I think you see the influence of both reflected in their performances, constantly pushing each other.
A little pianist routine into a dive onto Dark Beluga's back.
Just breathtaking by Yannick. Precise, controlled, harmonious. Everything you want from a freestyle performance.
He's within .09 of the score of Lambert Leclesio. The pressure is on very much so with that stunning freestyle program. He was second in the compulsory, second in the freestyle. Just dropped down a little bit on Thursday with fourth in the technical test, but that is a freestyle to finish, and we wait to see whether he could win the world title still, Hannah.
He's always so beautiful to watch because he is such a harmonious, soft vaulter, and I love that it's set to piano music as it like utterly highlights that quality. But we have to talk about Dark Beluga and Barbara Rosny as well, who also won the bronze medal as part of the pas de deux with Janneke Dirks and Johannes Key yesterday in that unbelievable competition.
And I was more focused on Yannick during the performance, but the way Dark Beluga trotted out with that energy and suspension, he's going to get good horse mark score as well, I would think.
And I think it's so great that the horses had a day off yesterday. They've really come back revitalised, ready to take on the competition. But look at the replay of Yannick here. Elegance personified.
And Yannick actually credits his mother with his launch into vaulting, because he started in football and then his mum said, come on, try vaulting. So hats off to Frau Hyland, and we wait for the score for Yannick.
But he gave everything there, so it was so interesting to see what happens here.
It is a massive 8.974. That has given Yannick Hyland a real chance of the gold medal. The pressure is phenomenal now on the last to come. Brilliant score.
Just absolutely thrilled for him. And look at that combined total there, 8.606. And that is testament to the quality that he's shown us over all four rounds here in Tryon.
And the other extraordinary thing is that he's best friends with the Brusewitz brothers. In fact, he shares a flat with Yannick. And it's Thomas who's in the silver medal position. It's a German 1-2-3 at the moment with one man standing.
And it's brilliant to see the camaraderie between fellow countrymen here in Tryon. They may be competing against each other, but they're all teammates and friends as well.
But the world number one has got the stage to himself. He was third in the opening, fourth in the freestyle, and that technical test has put him on top of the world as the last to come. He starts on 8.572 as opposed to Yannick Hyland's 8.483. And he's smiling. Maybe it's a sort of grimace, but I don't think so. This man is so composed. He's now ready to deliver the performance we know he can produce.
He vaults with sheer brilliance, and we saw that throughout the technical round. To score an 8.4 in the technical test is testament to his outstanding skill.
Sixth individually in Caen 4 years ago, and born in Mauritius. He's been vaulting now since the age of 11.
And this horse took the gold medal 4 years ago in Normandy with Jacques Ferrari. Look at the way he connects the movements.
Yeah, the compactness of the spin into those dismounts.
Bah,
brilliant.
So artistic throughout. No hesitation between the movements. Wow.
The gauntlet has been thrown down by the Germans, but the French number one is responding in brilliant fashion. That was incredible, Hannah. The pressure is so strong on him, but Lambert Leclercio has just come out and said, I am not frightened, I'm here to win. And I think with that performance, he will do that.
There are no words to describe what he just performed there. That was an utter masterclass. Sheer brilliance.
He won the world title by winning at Le Mans, but he aims for his first FEI World Equestrian Games gold medal here. That was as a Mauritian representative, and he had great support from the FEI in order to train and compete in Europe ahead of the Le Mans World Championships. And sportsman of Mauritius's history. That was in 2016, Sportsman of the Year award. The crowd is screaming. That was a piercing performance.
Yeah, I don't know if I've ever witnessed anything like it before. He continually pushes the boundaries of the sport, and he really marks a new era with global vaulting. It is outstanding to watch. See there the emotion, but it's the way he connects the different elements from the lever up through the handstand down to the bridge to show his back and shoulder flexibility. Then he kicks up out and goes into an outside bounce. I have never seen anything like it before. And then the backflip to finish off his routine. And you see the emotion there from Lambert, thoroughly deserved.
Yes, it's just been packaged up this week as he's been trying to keep the media pressure at bay, his own, I'm sure, perfectionist traits. And to come out when, yeah, the Germans are just lining up behind him. First, second, third as he enters the arena. To deliver that performance, we must have huge respect.
Yeah, but he's come here to try on with a whole new confidence to his vaulting. He has always been exceptional, but this year he has stepped up a level. And what a place to do it, on the World Equestrian Games stage. And you see there a standing ovation from the audience. He is just something else alongside his lunger and his amazing horse. They are an amazing combination.
His lead was about 90 thousandths coming into the final freestyle of the World Equestrian Games for the individual competitions, but that execution with a high degree of difficulty, Hannah, we are fairly certain it's got to be the third world title of all time going to France.
That marks a new level in the sport. And he really is the one to beat because he is so phenomenal across the board. He's got great flexibility, strength, control, but it's his artistry that really sets him apart from the field.
Mathias Lange won the first French world title in 2002 in Jerez, and Jacques Ferrari won in Normandy, a 9.262, 9.782 from Doris Knotter for technique from Austria.
Yeah, exactly, and you see there the technical marks as well were so close to 10 because the degree of difficulty is phenomenal and the way he performs the exercises is unmatched. Look what it means to Lambert.
And Lambert Le Clerciot is the 2018 FEI World Champion here in Tryon. Quite astonishing. He's getting a standing ovation already for this quite groundbreaking performance.
And it is exactly that, groundbreaking. Look at the average score from him, 8.744. Just outstanding. And the standing ovation could not be more deserved because people know that they're witnessing something historic here in Tryon. And what a competition we've witnessed here. The quality and the level has been so high. Everybody has risen to the occasion. But the moment really belongs to Lambert because he is so phenomenal. And he is changing the dynamics of the sport. Just outstanding.
Well, thank you so much to Hannah Eccles for her input over the days here in Tryon. And it's incredible celebrations for France. As he takes the scalp of Yannick Heiland, Thomas Brusewitz, and Yannis Druhl. 1, 2, 3, and 4 for Germany. And Juan Martin Clavio, he is fifth for Colombia. He's just gradually built up his attack during the week. And there you see the confirmation. Lambert Le Clerciot becomes the world champion here in Tryon with Poivre Vert for France. Clear of Yannick Heiland, who was simply brilliant, with Dark Beluga. Germany win their 12th medal with that for Yannick Heiland. The Thomas Brusewitz, he wins the bronze with Danny Boy. It's been a fantastic male final. And our congratulations to Lambert Le Clerciot and also to the Americans. As we say, Colton Palmer has got a big, big future at just 19 years of age. We hope you've really enjoyed the coverage, and we will bring you the prize giving to celebrate the French victory in just a few moments' time. Please bear with us. We're back with you shortly. Thank you so much for watching.
Competition will start tonight at 5 o'clock with 12 teams. So stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We're having a little ceremony for the World Individual Vaulting Championship Male Division. Let me have just a moment. Getting the horses all set now. They need to have their coolers on and their ribbons as well. Yeah, it's about that. We're ready to go. Stand by.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are just preparing for the prize giving after a quite enthralling male final freestyle competition to complete the individual competitions here for the vaulting in the indoor stadium at the FEI World Equestrian Games in Tryon. And it was simply a brilliant week from both the ladies and the men. And we welcome in just a moment the three who have prevailed over a very competitive start field. The 21 medals have been awarded so far over the seven editions since Stockholm in 1990 for the inception of the FEI World Equestrian Games. And Germany have won two of the world titles, Michael Lehner in 1990 and Kai Vorberg in Aachen in 2006. And France have also won two prior to Tryon, Matthias Lang in the Reth in 02 and Jacques Ferrari in 2014. We are delighted to welcome in the third world champion for France. The quite sensational Lambert Leclerc comes forward. Born in Mauritius, and he quite simply blew the field apart with his final freestyle. Germany have been very strong as ever, claiming silver and bronze. And Yannis Druhl denied a medal by his good friend Thomas Brusewitz, who moved up into the bronze medal position after his very strong freestyle performance. Delighted to welcome our presenting party for the men's vaulting. And Itsuna Kazu Takeda, the FEI Honorary Vice President and member of the International Committee for the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, who will make the medal presentations. And in bronze, we congratulate Thomas Brusewitz. He was fourth last time in Caen, and it's individual bronze for him. The silver goes to Yannick Hyland. 26 years of age and impressive his debut at the World Equestrian Games, but this very special young man, he goes back to congratulate his horse Poivre Vert and his longer François Attimont before coming forward to mount his podium. The world champion, ladies and gentlemen, Lambert Leclerc for France, the world number one. His second World Games, he was sixth in Caen, but he touches gold here in Tryon with a sensational final freestyle that there was no doubt left in anybody's minds that he would win the gold. Tsunekazu Takeda, the FEI Honorary Vice President, making the award now to Yannick Hyland, accompanied by Barbara Rosini, his lunger. Yannis Druhl's already received his bronze, as has Lars Hansen. But the gold medal winner is Lambert Leclerc for France. And François Attimont, his lunger, it's a gold as well. And our warmest congratulations after a simply blistering week from the Frenchman. And congratulations to Poivre Vert, his beautiful black horse who kept his composure, kept his calmness to allow Lambert to just show a dazzling array of moves and to clinch the world title. Just congratulating our winners, Meg Atkinson, the Tri and Resort lead broker, and from our sponsors here in the vault and Christie's International Real Estate. Meg awarding the flowers to the Frenchman. And Sharon is the Chief Operating Officer here at the Tryon International Equestrian Centre.
On behalf of our team, we welcome Juan Carlos Capelli to present the Longines watches to the medalists.
And delighted to welcome forward as well, and timepieces to go to Thomas Brusewitz. Here's Lunger. To Yannick Hyland and to Barbara Rossini from Juan Carlos Capelli, the Vice President and Head of International Marketing at Longines. His company, so loyal to equestrian sports. And the timepieces which have been garnered to all of our medal winners has been lavish. Thank you so much to Longines and Juan Carlos Capelli. And we all stand for the Marseillaise to welcome in the new world champion. Is a very strong case as being the strongest nation in male vaulting, because they've won now three world titles back to back after Normandy. Jacques Ferrari has great company in Lambert Lecrezio, the winner here in Tryon. Congratulations, and well, we can only imagine the tireless training, the hours, and also all of the logistic problems bringing Poivre-Vert over to the USA. And the team behind Lambert also, mum and dad, and the whole team to support this precocious young talent to the world title. Two more medals added to the German collection. Their total tally is now 13 after the victories. The silver and the bronze for Yannick Hyland and Thomas Brusewitz. And France extend their medal haul to 6 after Lambert Lecrezio's, but crucially, the first nation in the history of male vaulting at the World Equestrian Games to have won the male world title on 3 occasions.
Another great finish to the FBI World Equestrian Games. The individual male vaulting title is determined tonight by 0.1. And if the athletes are ready,
and Lambert himself is just 21 years of age.
Come on, this is another appearance.
and he performed simply majestically to pick up the world crown here in Tryon. Oh, congratulations. Yannick Hyland, Thomas Brusewitz for Germany. But the tricolour will parade here, I'm sure, a few more times yet, and some exciting rivalries will start to develop over the forthcoming years between the young guns. And it's the biggest hitter for France, who takes the Tryon world title. Lambert Pezio, the champion. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a memorable male vaulting final, but it's not over yet, because 12 squads will come back to contest for the last medals of the vaulting, and that is at 5 o'clock in just over 1 hour. We'll see you then for the final vaulting showdown from Tryon. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you later.